Hey, I'm William. Today, I'm going to show you how to replace the door switch on a GE dryer. The door switch completes the electrical circuit when the door is closed so the dryer can start running. It's also a safety feature that's designed to prevent the dryer from operating when the door is open. You might need to change out this part if it failed testing or has been damaged. Before we get started, hit those like and subscribe buttons if you want to join our do-it-yourself repair community and get notified each time we post a new video guide. With over 2 million products in stock and the know-how to help you do it yourself, we are ApplianceParts.com. As far as tools go, all we'll need today is a Phillips screwdriver. Also, please remember that safety comes first. Always disconnect your dryer by unplugging it or switching the breaker off before you work on it. Now let's get started. You can find the door switch on the front panel. We're going to use our Phillips screwdriver to remove the two screws at the top of the front panel, just behind the door. Now we're going to lift the top panel up just a bit so we can clear the console legs and pull it forward. We're going to remove the Phillips screws that are found at each back corner of the front panel. Once we've done that, we can lift the front panel up, rotate it to the side, and lean it against the frame. Then we can rotate the plastic cover out of the way. It's a good idea to take a photo of how the wires are attached so that we have a reference point when we put the wires back on. Once you've got the photo, you can start removing the wires. We're going to pinch the two tabs on the switch into the door switch body, then push it out of the front panel. Here's the old door switch and here's the new one. If you've already got one, great. If not, you can pick one up at ApplianceParts.com. Our new switch is being pushed into place where it will lock into place, and now we can connect the door switch wires. To put the dryer back together, we're going to set the front panel onto the dryer. We need to secure it with the screws we removed earlier. Now we're going to slide the top panel on the console legs, rotate the top panel down, and then secure it with the long Phillips screws we removed from behind the door. And that's all there is to it. Just don't forget to plug your dryer back in or flip that circuit breaker back on. You made it to the end. Awesome work, and thanks for spending your time with us today. Let us know how your repair experience went by dropping a comment below. If you still need a door switch, write down your dryer's model number and visit ApplianceParts.com to place your order. Your part should be at your doorstep within just a few days. And while you're here, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. We have tons of troubleshooting and repair guides waiting for you, plus all the parts you need to do it yourself at ApplianceParts.com. Your support means a lot to us, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.